But yeah, part of me wants to shoot Emily right now, but I really don't want to shoot her. Like, I just hit my mic. Sorry about that if you heard that. Like, part of me wants to shoot Emily. Like, I am really, really tempted to shoot her because I'm not sure if it works this way in the game, but in Native American folklore, if you get bit by a Wendigo, you turn into a Wendigo. Like, there's no saving it. There's no saving you. So I'm not sure what I want to do here. Like, I don't know whether to just shoot her and be done with it, but then I don't have everyone alive at the end. Or do I save her? Just in case if it doesn't work the way I think it works. Spinelli, welcome to the stream. Nice to meet you. I do hope you enjoy your stay. Hashtag Team Emily. Not even bad. I mean, we hate her, so why not? But I do want to try and get to the end of the game with... Well, she wouldn't get bit if you did certain choices different. I mean, I had a feeling that'd be the case. I mean, do we really need everyone alive? We could just take the doggo back with us instead. I mean, you're not wrong, but I've been trying my hardest so far, so I'm not gonna shoot her. I'm so tempted. I'm so tempted, but I'm not gonna do it.
An eye on her. If you see anything weird, you guys know what to do.
Yeah.
No one leave. Okay? It's not safe out there. I'll be back soon.
I think this is a huge mistake. I mean, it could be. It could come back to bite us in the ass. But right now, she isn't a threat, and I'm thinking I'm gonna need my bullets.
I thought that he was gonna help us.
With a flamethrower, dude?
Now we don't have a chance.
No, guys, it just means we've gotta be tough. We've gotta do this on our own.
I don't know if I can.
Okay, reading. Only a few men have dared to hunt the Wendigo. I am the only
man. This guy's a little OCD.
Shut up and let me read, Ashley. I am the only man who has ever kept them under control. Heed these words, or it shall be your death, and your death will not be the last. The Wendigo must be contained. The Wendigo grows out of cannibalism. When a human is desperate and craves food, trapped on the mountain in the fierce winter storms, when he has eaten nothing for many days, the Wendigo spirit will begin to possess him. Even the strongest man is weak to it. He will kill without remorse, often those companions who have traveled with him. He will eat the flesh raw from the corpses. I have seen this happen many years ago. A craving for flesh that cannot be sated. And then the change begins. The eyes turn first and become milky and white. Then the teeth become longer, like fangs. The creature grows, and the skin is pulled taut across the bones. Stronger than human skin, but that's been scribbled out. I've been going for 2 hours and 10 minutes. Not even bad. Got about 50 minutes to go. 55, roughly. Actually, I've basically got another hour to go. Before I'm done. Okay, let's turn the page. What else we got? There was a tribe that lived in these mountains, the Cree. Their shamans tell stories of tall creatures.
A lot of history to this.
Ashley? Woman? I am trying to read. Let me read, woman. Their shamans tell stories of a tall creature born in ice. The tribe respected the mountain and all the animals which lived on it. The mountain became sacred to the Cree. Every animal became sacred also. The Cree believed it was bad luck to harm an animal on the mountain and would hunt elsewhere. In 1893, the miners arrived. They found tin and later traces of radium. They mined deep into the sacred mountain. The Cree say that the mountain cried out and the spirit was released. impossible to know slash verify if any of this is true. A mining disaster survivor, not something to survivors, death toll rises. Okay, let's wait for Ashley to say a little bit before I read.
It says that because the Wendigos are mutated from humans, when they hunt us, they know how to perfectly mimic their prey.
Yeah, I knew she was going to say something. Alright, the Wendigo's eyes change. They become both sharper and more dim. The Wendigo sees movement. It is a hunter like a hawk, but it cannot see stillness. If you are to keep totally still, then the Wendigo will not be able to see you. The skin and flesh of the Wendigo are hard like armor. They seem to feel no pain. They cannot be cut or stabbed. Even bullets will not pierce their skin, though a shotgun will keep them at bay. Because the Wendigo is mutated from a human, it knows how to hunt us. It can perfectly mimic its prey. You must remain sharp and disciplined. I have killed... He put 8 but scribbled it out and put 6. I have killed 6 Wendigos. Knives or bullets will not harm them. Use a flamethrower. It is the best weapon. Fire envelops them, burns away their skin, and makes them weak. But try not to kill them. Killing a Wendigo should be the last resort. Death releases the Wendigo spirit into the air. I have contained them. I use traps to catch them and fire to drive them into cages. The traps were baited with human limbs from those who had no further use for them. Nice. One by one, I caught those who had infested the mountain. So that is actually good to know. Like, we should never kill a Wendigo. Like, never kill it. Otherwise, the spirit will be released and inhabit somebody else on the mountain. Okay. So that's probably how there was a Wendigo, like, 60 years after the miners came back up from the mine. Like, someone else had gone up the mountain and the Wendigo spirit possessed them. Like Emily, perhaps. Yeah, possibly. I mean, right now we haven't read anything that says anything about bites. But at the moment, for all we know, all the Wendigos are around. Like, none of them have died yet. So, you know, their spirits are still in the Wendigo bodies and haven't moved elsewhere, which means Emily could be safe. Who knows? Oh, here we go. You gonna say anything, Ashley? I'm waiting for it. No? There may be defenses. Shamans wrote of rituals. I have found native artifacts on the mountain and copied them. Totems, bunches of herbs and feathers. I copied their designs. I have tested them out on the mountain. They work. They keep the Wendigo at bay. Not entirely, but enough. But inside buildings, they do not work. Hunger cravings, skull plus ribcage found miles apart. Who survived the collapse? Relatives? Cree legends say that the Wendigo grows from the bite of another Wendigo. But the bite is harmless. I have been bitten, but I did not change. The only way is to eat the flesh of another. There is no other way. Oh, wow. So, the bites are harmless. She's not going to turn into a Wendigo.
What does it say?
Yeah, let's reassure, you know, the bites are fine. I knew it, you made a mistake for sparing it. It said the bites are fine, like, you don't change if you get bitten, like, the bites are harmless.
It says that the bites, if it bites you, it's not infectious. It doesn't do anything.
Let me see that.
I'm sorry, what did you say?
It says she'll be okay.
It says what? You're gonna be fine.
Fine? Michael almost shot me, is that
he
fine?
He didn't shoot you.
And this bitch almost let him.
Hey, that's not fair, she was scared.
I'm the one who's scared.
I'm sorry, Emily. I didn't know what was going to happen.
None of us know. There's no excuse,
Emily. Please, just try to understand.
Understand the palm of my hand, bitch.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
Shit. We've got to get to Mike. Like, now.
See, you should have shut her.
Oh, Joshua, you should have listened to me. Because of your choices, people have died. I don't know which is worse, actively triggering events that lead to someone's death, or passively allowing a tragedy to occur. Because you couldn't lift a goddamn finger to help someone else. Remember last year, huh? You left your poor sisters to die. You did nothing to help. Paralyzed by your own self-centered fear, while a real threat was closing in. Now it's all about you, Josh. It's always all about you. Your game has gone terribly wrong. And your friends, like your sisters, have deserted you. You're all alone. Can you feel how cold your loneliness has become, huh? Why did you hurt them? Joshua, why did you hurt them?
Okay. Let's get caught up with chat. Ash deserved it? I mean, yeah, I guess so. Like, sure, she was scared with the lack of information that she had on bites and monsters, you know, so she may have overreacted a little bit. But honestly, she should have tried to think through it clearly. Like, If you get bit by a regular dog, you don't turn into a dog. If you get bit by a cat, a lion, you know, if you get bit by anything else in the world, you don't turn into that thing. So, like, going by that kind of logic, it's like, no matter what bites you, it's like, you're not going to turn into it. So, yeah. Like, I guess she did kind of deserve that, because she was kind of egging Mike on to shoot her. And yeah, Hammerhead's just like, so we just need to slap Emmy as well, because like, yeah, I mean, sometimes a nice smack will get someone's head straight. Correct, Danny. So yeah, we just need to give Emily a nice slap. Hit her upside the head. I mean, you do have a point there, Saffron. You do have a point. She did have a traumatic night with ghosts. But she found out that that was all Josh's doing. It wasn't any kind of ghost, so, like, she didn't really have anything to be traumatic about other than being punched in the face by Josh, which, again, she deserved, because as playing as Ash, we did stab Josh in the shoulder. So, yeah. But yeah, I didn't hurt anyone. They hurt me. Yeah, let's go with that. They hurt me.
But they didn't hurt you, Joshua. Not intentionally. They made a stupid mistake, and a terrible tragedy befell your sisters. I did not intend for that to happen. It just did. And they were sorry, at least, until you subjected them to your night of horrific torture.
It was just a game. I'm so sorry. Yeah, Yeah.
Let's hope that it's not too late for atonement. And that your friends, if they still are your friends, can save you from this terrible isolation.
Previously on Until Dawn.
Oh my god, guys, thank god!
What took you so long?
It's not so good up there right now. Oh, he's gone. We're too late.
Shh, quiet.
Wait!
Don't move.
What are you looking for?
Another way out.
Mike, there's no key for the cable car.
Josh, he's gotta have it.
And what is all that?
It may have taken him down to the mine.
I was down there. It's horrible. There'd been a cave in the 50s, I guess, and these miners got trapped down there.
Em, what is
the... Huh?
This is the safe room, Em!
Please.
Fuck, I can't do this.
Oh my God. You did the right thing.
Keep an eye on her. I'll be back soon.
Okay. I find Doctor the best part of the game. Honestly, Saffron, I am in agreement that I do love the quote-unquote therapy sessions we get. They're a really nice touch, and they break the fourth wall a lot, which I love it when just, like, certain characters break the fourth wall, which is why I like Deadpool so much, I should say. Okay. Away we go. Monokuma? It said despair. Hopefully someone got that, lol. Wait, what? I have no clue what you're talking about right now, Hammerhead. None at all. I was making a joke. It just went right over my head. There's got to be a totem in this room. I'll be very surprised if there isn't. There is an anime about despair. There is a bear named Monokuma. Oh. You know what? Drop me a message on Skype or something with the name of that anime in, and I'll totally look it up after the stream. And when I say after the stream, I mean after I finish doing what I need to do after the stream. I need to do some cleaning after I finish streaming. But yeah. Okay, back in the sanatorium. Does this mean we're gonna get to see our wolf friend? I wanna see my wolf friend that I made last time I was here. Right, is this... I know this is a totem. This is a death totem, isn't it? Yeah, I think, I don't think we're going to be running into any new totems, because, unless we get to a new area. Because, yeah, that's that death totem right there. I haven't gotten enough totems yet to warrant me looking at the events of the past again. Just yet. Like, I've only got, like, one more totem so far this stream? If that? No, yeah, it's definitely been one. I know I've gotten one this stream. I picked one up as Chris, didn't I? Was it Chris? Was it Emily? I think it was... My memory is so terrible.
Holy shit.